All right. Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praises and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. Yahweh being the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Shai being the Heavenly Father's Son, and double honors to the apostles of Great Millstone, the true elders of Israel today. And salutations to the hopeful elect out there pushing this truth and sincerity. All right, I want to get into the fact that reincarnation is real and it happens to everyone. Reincarnation, meaning the rebirth of a spirit through a new body. All right, this is Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 7. Then shall the dust return to the earth as it was, and the spirit shall return unto the Heavenly Father Yahweh who gave it. All right. Now to prove that everything comes from the dust of the earth, I'm gonna bring out Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 20. All go unto one place, all are of the dust, and all turn to dust again. Alright? Now I'm going to break down, get back to Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 7 again. Then shall the dust return to the earth as it was, and the spirit shall return unto the Heavenly Father Yahweh who gave it. All right, so this is talking about when you die, your body obviously goes back to the earth. It gets buried, or if it doesn't get buried, the earth will still consume it. All right, and your spirit will go to the spiritual world where the Heavenly Father Yahweh is. And from there, he gives you your judgment, brings you back, and you get your judgment on earth. Okay? I'm going to bring out a precept. In Psalms chapter 104, verse 29. Thou hidest thy face, they are troubled. Thou takest away their breath, they die and return to the earth. It's like in return to the dust. All right, now this is Job. No, it's like this is not Job, but I'm gonna get to Job. This is the scriptures explaining when you go when you're about to die, when you finally die, what happens to you. All right, because it says thou hidest thy face. Okay, so why would you hide your face? Because there's been a number of accounts that people can predict their death, right? Like sometimes a person might say, "Hey, I have a bad feeling about something," and then later on that day, they die. All right. So it says, and usually when that happens, they feel mad, disturbed, so they don't want to leave the house. They really don't want to do anything, you know. But let's say if they, you know, that's the scripture say, thou hidest thy face. They are troubled. All right. All right. Thou takest away their breath. All right. So the Heavenly Father is going to get to you no matter what. All right. They die and return to their dust. Okay. So there's no escaping the Heavenly Father. Whether if you want to stay in your house that day, You know, the Heavenly Father is always going to have a way to get to you. Thou sendest forth thy spirit, they are created, and thou renewest the face of the earth. Okay, so after you go into the spiritual world, the Heavenly Father sends you back to the earth to be renewed on the face of the earth, right? To be born again, on the face of the earth. All right, I'm gonna read that again. This is Psalms chapter 104, verse 29. Thou hidest thy face; they are troubled. Thou takest away their breath; they die, and return to the dust. Thou sendest forth thy spirit, they are created, and thou renewest the face of the earth. All right. Now, I'm gonna jump into the book of Job, because Job talks about it also. This is Job 19, verse, and I'm start at verse 25. For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. Okay, so Job knows that the Lord is going to come back. All right, he knows that the Lord is going to come back in the day of judgment. All right. And he knows that he's going to see him, all right, because he knows that reincarnation exists, it happens. He knows that it's going to happen to him, okay? For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see Yahweh. Alright. Now, this is getting into when he dies. He knows that, okay, the worms are going to consume his body, but he's still going to see the Lord. Alright. And though after my skin worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see Yahweh, whom I shall see for myself, and my eye shall behold, and not another. Okay? So he's saying, I'm going to see him for myself. Nobody's going to see him for me. I'm going to see him for myself. All right? I'm going to witness the day of judgment in my flesh. All right? Whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and not another, though my reins be consumed within me. Okay? So that's the breakdown right there. I hope you brothers was edified. And this is the brother Bashar. And I want to give our praises and glory to Yahweh Bahashim, Yahweh Shai. And double honors to apostles of Great Millstone who rule well. And salutations and honor to the hopeful elect pushing this truth and sincerity. Shalom.